So now, this is where we do a bit of sky at night. If we can have the lights down, please. I'm going to point out all the alkali metals, or the group 1 metals. We have them hovering above you. So hydrogen is here. This is hydrogen. And it's only got one electron, of course, and here is its one electron moving around. We can see they're all lit up. So this is hydrogen. Next, we go to lithium. Well, lithium is shown up here. And again, this has one electron in its outermost shell. Okay? This is what all of the elements in group 1 have in common. They all have one electron in their outermost shell. Sodium is shown at the back here. And there is its outermost electron, one electron again in its outermost shell. This is what we see on the screen here as well. Sodium with its single electron in the outermost shell. The next element is potassium, and again, this has many more electrons, many more protons, many more neutrons in the nucleus there, but again, one electron in its outermost shell. Potassium is shown over there. Okay, and there is its outermost electron, all by itself. Next element, what do we come to after potassium? We come to rubidium. Again, one electron in its outermost shell. Rubidium is shown up here. And there is its electron. Okay, one electron in its outermost shell. Finally then, we get to the largest member. Look at all these neutrons and protons in the nucleus here. Many, many neutrons and protons in the nucleus. And this gives it all its mass. It's very heavy indeed. Many, many electrons, but still just one outermost one. And this is the important thing. All of the group 1 elements have one electron in their outermost shell. And here's our cesium, and there's its outermost electron moving around on the atom up here. So this is the important thing. One other thing that's rather interesting, actually, is the scale of these atoms. We've shown all the electrons rather clustered around the nucleus here, but actually, these electrons are much further spaced out. The nucleus makes up all the mass of the atom, so it's all concentrated in the heart of the atom, but these electrons are really spread out. And if they're on this sort of scale that you see here, these electrons should be up to around 1 kilometer away from the nucleus here. So the vast majority of the atom is actually empty space, and the electrons are moving around that space. But these atoms, these group 1 atoms, are actually the largest atoms in the periodic table. Cesium is the largest atom there is. Okay.